Why aren't apes evolving into humans anymore? Let's continue talking about the various myths related to human evolution. Let's start by looking at what is perhaps myth number one on the list of anti-evolutionist arguments. Nobody has ever seen an ape turning into a human. I have deliberately not dealt with this myth yet, because it has already been addressed by many reputed scientists. I will now say a few words about that, but will do so in my own way, trying not to repeat what others have already said. I've just attended a science festival in Moscow, where someone asked me a question: why aren't apes evolving into humans? At least three times. Surprisingly, it was posed by well-educated people. I think the reason is that the phrase humans evolved from apes and monkeys has really become a catchphrase that represents the entire theory of evolution in the mind of most lay people. In other words, the whole theory of evolution has been compressed into this single phrase. So, if we take this phrase literally, then if we go to a zoo, we should see monkeys jumping to their feet, shedding their tails and hair, and turning into handsome lads and lasses, depending on their biological sex. However, nobody has ever seen that happen, so scientists must be hoaxing people, right? Well, not quite. The truth is, this phrase is a major simplification. For instance, it doesn't say what particular kind of apes had evolved into humans. So if someone tells you that apes are not turning into humans, you should ask, what apes do you mean exactly? There are more than 400 species of primates currently living in our planet, none of which is our ancestral species. By the way, it's interesting how mass culture works here. Take for instance a popular movie called Night at the Museum. There's a scene where one protagonist, Terry, asks another one, Larry, who's evolved? Who's evolved? While pointing his finger at a capuchin monkey. But capuchins are New World monkeys that inhabit South America. Of course they're primates, but they're only very remotely related to us, as our lineages separated more than 30 million years ago. But the movie implies that the capuchin is a human ancestor that just failed to evolve. That is complete nonsense. In other words, it must be understood that no modern primate is our ancestor and that the apes that had once embarked on the path of evolving into humans now exist only as fossilized bones. They are long extinct. Of course, if we're going to speak of anyone at all in this context, it should be the great apes, especially the chimpanzee, our closest relative in terms of constitution, genetics and biochemistry. But chimps are also not our ancestors. If we look at our distant quadruple ancestor who lived, the proconsul, here he is in the picture, who lived about 15 million years ago, and compare this creature with the modern human, we will see that our two species are quite different. The proconsul is also ancestral to other great apes, namely chimpanzees, gorillas and orangutans, but does not resemble any of them. Furthermore, they do not resemble each other. For instance, in the course of evolution, our ancestors' legs had been lengthening in relation to their arms. But for chimp ancestors of chimps, it was the other way around. Their arms had been lengthening in relation to their legs. Our cuspids had been shortening, and we're proud of that, but chimp cuspids, and generally their teeth and jaws, were growing bigger. A feature that is often considered quintessentially human is concealed ovulation. That is, women do not show external signs of ovulation. And looking at a woman, one cannot tell the phase of her menstrual cycle. But looking at a female chimpanzee, uninformed people sometimes ask, does she have a disease? What is that swelling? She gets a swelling that looks something like a red soccer ball. In fact, that is swelling of the female chimp's genital skin. When she is ovulating and is ready for mating, she uses it to signal the male that she is ready and available. But if we look at female gorillas and orangutans, we won't see any such external signs of ovulation. It must be a specific feature of chimpanzees, which has emerged in the course of their evolution. So here is what I'm trying to say. While our ancestors were evolving into humans, the chimpanzee ancestors were also not sitting idle. They were turning into chimpanzees. And in order for chimps to suddenly turn into humans, well, suddenly does not work because this has taken millions of years. But in any case, the chimp would first have to rewind its revolution by about 10 million years in order to return to its primitive ancestral form. But this is impossible. Besides, neither chimps nor other apes actually need to do that. There is truth to the joke that apes are not evolving into humans because they're afraid that they will be forced to work. In other words, if chimp evolution continues, it will not move towards humanity, but rather in the direction of an ultra-chimpanzee, although unfortunately the more likely forecast for modern hominids is extinction, given how much we humans are contributing to their disappearance. There's one more interesting point to make. Comparing a human with other primates, we view ourselves as the ultimate example of progress. But if we look closer at other simians, we will see that in many ways we are the ones who are behind in our evolution. Traditionally, the following features are described as quintessentially human: a large brain, bipedalism, and the ability to throw spears at elephants. But there are also other features that are just as important. For example, in the course of evolution, our somatognathic system has been reducing, and this is considered to be a progressive feature. This has led to the fact that our third molars or wisdom teeth may erupt later in life, or never at all. But calotrichids, a cute little monkey species from South America, don't have wisdom teeth at all. Their third molars disappeared completely. We also consider our reduced cuspids to be an advanced feature. But the eyes, lemurs native to Madagascar, have no cuspids at all. In that sense, they have left humans far behind. By the way, our science editor, a well-known Russian anthropologist Stanislav Drobyshevsky, has published a book in Russian called The Non-Missing Link, where he describes plenty of monkey peculiarities just like this one. You should definitely check out this book. Another example, our ears are small and immobile. This feature too is considered to be evolutionarily advanced. But if we look at an adult gorilla or an adult orangutan, we won't find what? External ears. Their ears are so small and rudimental that they are completely hidden in the animal's thick fur. Thus, in terms of reduction of ear dimensions, gorillas and orangutans are far ahead of us. Such examples are very numerous. Summing up, we can't say for sure who is the fastest evolver. Is it our simian relatives or is it us humans? Because, as you can see, in many ways, we humans may actually look like a living fossil.